tonight from Las Vegas, Nevada. Super Bowl 58. Rodgers and the New York Jets versus Jalen Hurts and the Philadelphia Eagles.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. We count down to kickoff in what should be an epic one here, as it'll be the AFC champion New York Jets taking on the NFC champions, the Philadelphia Eagles. The long fortnight of Super Bowl week is over, and away we go in Super Bowl 58.
Pulls it in at the 13.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. So now here comes the Jet offense as they get ready to take over. They'll be led out by their highly decorated quarterback, Aaron Rodgers.
And no doubt he's living out a dream right now. He's had dating back to his first days of playing football as a kid. But he certainly can't get lost in the moment right now. There's still a Super Bowl to be played, and his offense, they're looking to him to be their leader. You can take it all in when it's over. Right now, you've got the biggest game of your life to win.
They start, and oh, right away, he lost the football.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home, the next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43. Well, they'll run it here on the jet sweep. And he's going to be met at about the 43. And credit the tackle to Derek Barnett.
Second and 9.
To throw, it's Rodgers. He finds Corey Davis. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles 30. And a quick throw here, that's complete.
And he's brought down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Into the red zone, it's Rodgers.
And that throw behind his man, he missed him, incomplete.
The tight end, C.J. Uzama, the intended receiver. And now it's second down.
Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
And darn right, they did something to disrupt that timing.
And the Jets are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line.
A lot of precision being shown on this opening drive. They've been methodical, they've been crisp, and as a reward, they're going to be set up with an early first and goal.
Cook is in. Touchdown, Jets. But just power football there down near the goal line. Give it to him. He's able to push his way across.
Yeah, they went heavy there. Sometimes you have those big offensive linemen come in, have to report like they're eligible. But all they're doing is getting a good stance, blocking, and getting their runner across the goal line.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Philly's offense getting ready, and Jalen Hurts ready to lead them. The second-round pick who started his career at Alabama, then finished with an electric senior season at Oklahoma.
As we begin the Super Bowl, we're looking at one of the game's most important players. And whether he's the centerpiece of the offense or taking a backseat to his teammates, offenses always look to the quarterback to be a leader in moments like this. He's got to be that calm, composed pillar out there who stays level-headed and keeps everyone focused on the task at hand.
Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their own 23.
And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
This Super Bowl, of course, just a huge one for this head coach. The first time he's walked the sidelines in a game of this magnitude, and you know, I might normally ask the cliche, what's going through his mind right now? But maybe the better question, CD, what do you think are the pitfalls of being a first-time head coach in this game?
Well, you know it's something that he thought about, Brandon, and he had to, and he was thinking about it long before he got to this stage. As the season progressed and he saw that his team was good, if he was smart, he started to make plans right then and there.
And that is caught one-handed. Oh, my, he pulled it in.
And he'll be brought down at about the 23-yard line.
Well, after the standard 2-week layoff, you always wonder, how's your offense going to respond and come out and play here in the Super Bowl? Well, they got a great answer right there and almost a sigh of relief on that side of the field, because now they've got to feel like they can use their entire playbook and game plan for this one.
Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down.
They'll stay on the ground with Swift.
And he'll take this one inside the 10, down to the 8. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Well, that'll be incomplete. He took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a 3rd down.
Here's play number 7 on the drive. This is 3rd and 7.
Hurts sets up to throw it.
And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown.
Grant Calcaterra
from 8 yards out.
And the Eagles are an extra point away from tying up this Super Bowl.
You got to figure down by the goal line, this is where a tight end earns his money, in the high traffic area. And he's able to work free in the middle of the end zone and grabs that one for a touchdown.
Elliott good on the extra point. And we are tied at 7. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And it was capped off by an Eagles touchdown. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away.
Pulls it in at the 13.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30.
Come on now. Let's do this.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. A long drive last time out for this offense, Charles. If you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
And partner, as a former defensive back, I'm having almost a physical reaction watching what's happening right now, but
Let's give credit where it's due because they've done an excellent job moving the ball through the air. Secondary getting picked apart pass by pass. Obviously, they need to make some adjustments there on the back end.
Yeah, because offensively, we know that they're not going to be shy about throwing that football.
First down, here's the run with Cook. And he'll work this forward for about three at second down.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you've got to continue to try and run and try and keep a defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
And across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory. The Eagles call on the extra defensive back here as they prepare for a stop on third down. They'll run it. Here's Cook. Now they nearly sprung him that time as he takes this all the way down to the 37. Give him 12 yards there, and the Jets have a first. Following the good run by Cook, here's another first and 10. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. Yikes, a 4-yard loss really sets him back now for second down.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Now they'll throw with Rodgers. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Here's Rodgers. Open man here is Conklin. Call it a gain of a yard, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. So coming on now is the field goal unit. They're going to try for three, and he'll need all the leg he's got here. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this is going to wind up left. Well struck, but it's no good, and this game will remain tied here in quarter number two.
Well, Brandon, anything beyond 50, you start rolling the dice a bit. And once you get up around 57, 58 yards, the chances of making it go down dramatically. And sure enough, this one winds up no good.
And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three. They'll try and run here with Swift. And he's going to be a yard short. A 2-yard pickup leads to fourth and one.
You know, we might start getting some props here in the booth. You know, that one that says the D and then the fence that you put up next to it. How about that? They brought out the jumbo package and still couldn't move them off the line of scrimmage enough to pick up that first down.
Impressive. They were ready defensively for that jumbo set.
They'll try it now with Swift. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Give them credit. They knew what they wanted to dial up on fourth. They executed it for 9 yards, and the offense stays out there. 2 minutes on the clock in the second quarter of this Super Bowl. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Play action. Here's Hurts. He'll rifle this one deep right side. Touchdown, Eagles. Dallas Goedert, 36 yards. And the Eagles have taken the lead. Well, they had gone run the previous play. Nice little setup. This time they go play action. Defense bites a bit, and they hit for a big play in the end zone.
So they sold it really well, didn't they? Because of just what you described, they ran it the previous play, come back with the same action, and now they step back and throw it and get a big play for a touchdown. But what happens as a defensive back is your eyes have to go to the right place. You always hear a coach talk about, are your eyes in the right spot? Well, this time the eyes went to the play action. It froze their feet. They weren't moving, and he went on past them and caught the pass for a touchdown.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. Now the Jets offense about set to take over as they head onto the field.
That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived as they've now given up two straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula that got them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they can get this game tied up.
Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Pressure comes, and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. They'll wind up losing 8 on the sack there, and it's second down. And when a free safety goes like he did there, he better be sure he's going to be able to make a play.
Oh, there's no doubt about it, because I have a feeling that the defensive coordinator and head coach are on the sideline screaming, no, 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 good play.
Yeah, good job, buddy. Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. Over the middle, it's complete. And he's going to be stopped here a few yards short of the first as the tackle is made at the 33.
Well, it looks like they got what they wanted. They got the completion, but they weren't able to break any tackles or gain nearly enough yardage to pick up the first down. Now to be fourth and short.
Now the Jets send on Braden Mann to punt. Take this across the 25 before going out of bounds. A very good kick there, but 15 yards on the return. And it will be Eagles football, first and 10. And the Eagles going to get one final possession in this first half. And with a 14-7 lead, they might just be happy to take this thing on into the tunnel. And just 25 seconds to go in the half now as they've got it first and 10. Oh, and Hurts is going to be hit and taken down to the ground. Carl Lawson. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number 1. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Going deep here for Watkins. And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. Touchdown, Philadelphia! Quez Watkins in the final seconds of the first half. And the Eagles continue to look good here in the first half of this Super Bowl. Elliott Good with a PAT, and it's now 21-7. Pretty clean and simple there, just 2 plays, the long pass resulting in the touchdown on play number 2. So 6 seconds, all that remains of this first half as the kick is away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. And the white flag coming out as they line up to kneel on it. And with time running short here, they'll simply take a knee and that should do it for half number 1. So we've come upon halftime in the big one, the Super Bowl. As we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. What a season this has been. Hard to believe it ends tonight. As we'll get back to you guys for the second half of this Super Bowl in just a moment.
These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in this Super Bowl. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble and bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. Out come the Eagles now as he'll go on offense first here in the third quarter. And I would imagine this is where you have to take stock of the situation, CD, and say, gosh, we're halfway to the Lombardi Trophy. Let's not slow down now.
And I like the way you went there. Let's not slow down now, because the first half certainly went their way. And I would expect them to continue with that type of a game plan. But you're right. You do think back to Super Bowl 54. 49ers had a double-digit lead in the fourth quarter, couldn't hold on. So plenty can still happen.
And, oh, he's unable to hold on to that defensively. A potential game changer, but it falls incomplete. They go play action with Hurts. That is caught. It's the tight end Goddard. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down convert. Off the play fake. Here's Hurts. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Swift going to try up the middle. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. 45 yards on the ground for him so far. A couple extra tight ends in the formation here as they line up third and two. Hurts towards the end zone for Brown. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. A.J. Brown, 52 yards. And the Eagles will extend their third quarter lead here in this Super Bowl. Well, he has been fun to watch throwing the football in this one. It's certainly not fun for that defense, though, Charles. Now up to four touchdown passes in this ball game.
Yeah, we're supposed to be neutral, but I'm feeling their pain right now because he has absolutely carved up this secondary. A clinic on how to attack a defense and take them out of the game.
Elliott on for the extra point. He knocks it through. It's 28-7. So the drive there took six plays. And it's capped off by an A.J. Brown touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Pulls it in at the 13. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. So here's the Jets offense now as they get ready for their first possession of the second half. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Now it's Rodgers. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Here's Rodgers to throw. And that one going to be off target and incomplete.
Well, partner, they certainly played up to their top 10 defensive ranking this week. They've stifled this opposing offense throughout this game. This contest is now lopsided because of their efforts, and there's still a quarter to go.
He's going to get this one down to Cook. And they'll get him down at about the 37, well short of the first. He did his best to just get four out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down. Here's the Jets punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. Oh, boy, he fielded it right on the goal line. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 10. Call that one an even 60 yards, 6-0. And the Eagles will be backed up deep to get the drive started as they take over first and 10. Coming out with a jumbo package to start the drive. On the ground, it's Swift to start the drive. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks. They had three tight ends in on that set, and they were really good at blocking for their running back.
And give them a lot of credit because
In football nowadays, tight ends coming out of college often don't block very often. These guys have really developed into superior blockers, and that's why they use them in this formation so often.
Third quarter, Super Bowl 58. Here's a second and 10 now. That's to Goddard. What a grab. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Over 100 yards receiving for him now in this Super Bowl.
This is just more of the same. This defense has had no answer on a lot of these throws. They've let these receivers run wild. And here's another completion for good yardage.
On first and 10, it's Swift. And good running there as he'll take this all the way up to midfield. 76 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night. First down, and they go with Swift again. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and 4.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And it's a leaping effort, but it's knocked away and incomplete.
Textbook coverage right there. Played the ball, never lost sight of where it was headed, and stayed in perfect position to make a play on it. Able to keep the receiver and the quarterback in his sight lines.
Here's Hurts to throw. This is caught. It's Brown. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets 16. That gain on third down, good for 28.
With the kind of game he's had so far, you had to know that on third down that they would be looking his way, and they did, for big yardage and a first down. I think the defense fell asleep at the switch on that one. I would have doubled him, tripled him, anything to keep the ball out of his hands.
Back to the running game with Swift. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Once again, it's Swift. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. A solid pickup of 12 yards, and now they're knocking on the door. We are through three quarters of play here from Allegiant Stadium in Super Bowl 58. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Swift will take this one in for an Eagles touchdown. Some good running there at the end of the drive. He had the burst that set up the first and goal, and then one play later, he's in the end zone.
Brandon, what I liked about that sequence is, I'm not sure who made the play call, but they understood the situation, understood the momentum. A nice hard-charging run, give it right back to him, and let him cap things off.
A 10-play drive that time, and it results in a 4-yard touchdown run. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. The offense for the Jets ready to take over. And it's becoming more and more apparent that this is just not going to be their night. That Lombardi Trophy so close, but the expectations simply have not matched the results as they start on this drive first and 10. Here's a throw, complete right side to start things out. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. Now Cook, he's got it off the draw. Now the offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted. Look at the eight. first down, Rodgers. And he will find his man on the end route, complete.
One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not... run after catch. They tackle them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
And he is going to have a Jets first down by about a yard. It's a gain of 5 on 3rd and 4. Two first downs have him up near midfield now on 1st and 10. Rodgers now to throw. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43. They'll come up now on 2nd and a yard. Rodgers going to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Cook. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line.
And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
Now a throw for the left sideline, and he's got it. That good for 6 as they keep this drive right on rolling. Give to Cook out of the gun.
And he gets forward up the middle, but only for a couple. It'll be 2nd down.
The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8. They'll try the wide side with Cook. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. It's a pickup of 3, and we have now arrived at the 2-minute warning. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. They face a 3rd down now as they try to find a late score. They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. Shotgun now for Rodgers. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And the Jets are going to have 1st and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
And this is caught. Well, they get one back, picking up the late touchdown here, but still down big.
McCann now for the extra point.
It's good, and it's now 35-14. So that drive, 12 plays in length, and it ends with a Jet touchdown. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. And the Eagles dodge a bullet. They cover it up. Now they're down big here in the 4th. They had to try the onside kick. Can't fault them for the effort at least.
No, you can't at all. And if nothing else, now you've put something that you're trying to practice, right, that you've worked on into a game situation, and now you can go back and dissect it. So if you need it again sometime, maybe you'll find a better way to do it. But, yeah, this game's pretty much done for them.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again 2nd and 10. Now a give right side Swift. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of 1 yard, so now they deal with 3rd and 11.
Now that's a nice play. Got me fired up, partner. But can they do it back-to-back plays? All the training that you go through as a defense for these situations, when you have to get the ball back, everything you go through, holding up the runner, raking at the football, getting to the passer, knocking it out of his hands, whatever way, they have to get the ball back.
Now can they stand tall again for a huge 4th quarter stop? Throwing is Hurts. And he's got his man. It's the tight end Goddard. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Now that's a big pickup right there. And so often we focus on how the quarterback's faking on play action. How about everyone being in on the deal and picking it up?
Second, third levels, you can see them trying to recover. They bit. Worked out offensively.
And the Lombardi Trophy will rest in the city of brotherly love. The Philadelphia Eagles are the Super Bowl champs.
And their remarkable season ends in the most remarkable of ways. They get to put next to their name, Super Bowl champion.
And they can't ever take that away, can they?
Nope.
That lasts forever. So good to see the emotion when it's all said and done. You see the hugs, you see the guys sharing, the collective happiness. Makes me want to carry you around a little bit on my shoulders to celebrate the triumph. And congratulations to them, a fantastic season.
The Super Bowl champs, the Lombardi Trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. What a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gaudin signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.